Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue the eating streak here in the Binding of Isaac Invicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for supporting the like streak as we go on to four and beyond. Speaking of four, we got 304 wins in a row. Seed day is going to be 9, November 9, 7, Yankee Papa Victor 0. We've got god-awful range, good tears rate, average damage, slightly better average damage, the D5, and Lump of Coal here. So, okay, and a fly that was moving very, very oddly at the start there. So, my voice is a little bit shot today, a little bit shot more than usual, but that seems to be the norm. Hey, we get our soul heart back anyway. And that's basically just due to the fact that, well, unfortunately, fortunately and unfortunately, I've been doing a lot of talking. Today on stream was like, I was finishing up the editing for the last two tournament videos, which is... It helps me. Of course, there's a lot of people who unfollow the channel, the Twitch channel, because it's like, yeah, I mean, we... And of course, I don't blame them. They come to the channel, look for gameplay, and I'm like, yeah, you know, that's definitely something that I would be... I'd be interested in if I was going to Twitch. But one thing that I was telling people was that, you know, it's okay to feel that way, I think, without making yourself feel entitled. As a viewer, but what I would say is, like, just give, you know, give something different a chance. You never know, you know? You never know. Oh, we got, like, double luck upgrade in there. Yeah. I don't like Shielded Tears here, and this is because, yes, we do have the tears rate to back it up, but I still dislike them, only because they interrupt the flow of the, well, of the shots. But what I mean is, though, if you see, like, one of your favorite streamers, and I'm not necessarily talking about my channel, I'm talking about, you know, anyone. If you see Day 9 playing a game that may, or editing or doing something that you like, maybe you wouldn't want. Oh, it's not. That's the D Infinity. Excuse me. How could I have been so foolish, D Infinity? Apologies. I was about to drop you like a bad habit and take the jump cartridge here. Just like I would say, just like, you know, maybe give it a chance before you unfollow a channel that you've been following for a little while, and maybe just. Well, you never know. I enjoyed answering questions that people had about editing. I mean, I knew that, like, it's unrealistic to think that, like, you know, you can edit on stream and you're gonna have just a bunch of people stick around, you know. Now, the people who do stick around, of course, they're very interested in what's going on. Ooh, we just broke the tears cap with the D Infinity. Now we have the D1 Hizzle, which I don't know if I want to use anymore. This did completely kill it. Like, this murdered our movement speed. Like, flat out. Somebody call the cops. There's been a murder. Do we want to stick with the D100? We don't really have a chance right, or a choice right now, but... The D-Infinity is... It can be good. It can also be terrible. The D8 really is where the terribleness lies, because while, yes, you can always recover stuff with the D100, like, you might roll into something a little bit better than what you got. With stats-wise, you can't really change that. Man, I'm loving this tears rate, though. We may have to stick around with this novelty act just because of the fact that we broke the tears cap. but yeah, that's the only thing that, excuse me? How did the game screen get clicked off there? That was weird. Yeah, I mean, like I said, if one of your favorite streamers is doing or playing something that maybe is not your jam, then I'd say just give it a chance. I mean, what's the harm, you know? You obviously followed that person for some reason. Maybe it's a... You know, maybe it's not your favorite game, but, you know, you can branch out. What's funny to me is that, like, I still get people just discovering the Darkest Dungeon series, Lobotomy Corporation. Like, a lot of people are like, you know, I've never even heard of this game. This is awesome, even though these videos are super old. Is this going to break the tier? It is. Well, now we can't D100 out of this. I mean, I wish that the D-Infinity hadn't gone straight to D100. But we got a 3 tiers rate, and we did it all natural. Excluding the fact that we had the D8 at one point. I mean, we started this run with an 8 tiers rate, and it dropped it down to 4, and then we just got Eden's Blessing, so that's That's pretty good. Got Dangle here. Now, there is one problem with this, and that's the fact that our range is just god-awful. But what's even more god-awful is our movement speed. 0.55 is about as low as it gets. Okay, range up. And we get the Pact and Guppy's Collar. Now, I don't remember how many Soul Hearts we had, but that's the reason why I'm doing it this way. Let's go into the store. Oh my god, the Pact also dropped our tiers rate too. This, and we get PhD as well. Wow. Go get Balls of Steel and an Eternal Heart. What is going on? I don't deserve this kind of treatment, game. The Sinvicta's luck account's going to be very unhappy about this. Or maybe not. Maybe this is something that was sanctioned. I don't know. Speaking of sanctioned, by the way, I want to say thank you to everybody who has been providing some kind words talking about the Eden series and whatnot. In particular, the like streak. Somebody brought up a good point about the like streak when I was saying, like, you know, there really isn't, right now anyway, there's not a whole lot of difference, a whole lot of variance in the Eden streak videos. And somebody was like pointing out, like, you know, there's no real incentive for the like streak. But then somebody, she said, why not give us a Daisy video for milestones and stuff? And I said, you know what? That's a good idea. It's a low entry point for me as far as the barrier of content goes, because it's very easy content to make. I can't guarantee it's going to be all content, but it might be non-content. And I was like, yeah, that's a good idea. So like every 30 likes, every 30 like streaks that we hit, we'll do a new Daisy video. It'd be me doing something with her. Maybe driving, I don't know, like riding around in a car, or me playing fetch with her. She loves to chase the toys that we throw for her out in the backyard. You know, something roo-roo-y like that. Or maybe just a minute-long video of her barking. Daisy's got a, she's got kind of a unique bark. It's very yippy, like a very yip 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 sort of small doggish. But she also has some bite to it. She has a little bit of an aggression problem, not towards people or anything. She thinks she's bigger than she is. And I swear to God, I swear that this dog has imaginary friends that she plays with, like as someone who had imaginary friends when he was growing up. Like I know exactly what she's doing. That's why, like, when I see her, she's going outside and she's like playing, she's barking, she's hooting and hollering and stuff. There's no other dogs around. She's just having fun. And I'm like, I'm telling you, like I was telling my dad, I was like, I think that she has make-believe friends that she's playing with. And when we're out there observing her, she's like showing off. You know, she's like showing off, like she's like having fun. Like she's imagining herself being partnered with other dogs or friends or, you know, or humans. I don't know. I just, who knows what the heck goes on in the mind of a dog. Anyway, yeah, that's what, didn't mean to go on that tangent, but that's a good idea. It really is a good idea. But my voice is super duper rough today. It's a little bit more hoarse than usual. And that's because I had to do all that editing, and then, of course, I had to talk through that, and then I had to do the voice lines for the tournament. And like, the voice lines, you may not think is like, oh, come on. Like, you say one line, and then you do the commentary. Like, that's already pre-recorded, blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, for the voice lines, I have to actually project a little bit more of my voice. And on top of that, like, I usually have, like, 10 different takes and stuff before I find one that I truly like. So say like Polyphemus over and over again, that actually does start to wear your voice down very quickly. That was just terrible. I tracked that one all the way through there. Okay. This room is awful, by the way. It shouldn't exist, and whoever designed it should not feel good about themselves today. Yes, please, for the love of anything, give me movement speed. We got PhD. What was this? Balls of Steel. That worked out very well. So what Verp does, Verp will summon the last pill that you essentially took. And since it was Balls of Steel a couple floors ago, that's going to be it. But we need movement speed. Like, even the point down to 0.63, like, it's better than nothing. With a goat hoof. So that's a good idea. That's not the only thing that I'm thinking about for the like streak, though. You know, it's just there's only so many ways that I can add variants to Isaac and to the Isaac content on the channel before it's like I don't know what else I can do. You know, inevitably when the streak ends, which the streak will end one day. It might be today. Well, unlikely, but it might be today. Who knows? You never know. You could get missing node, curse the blinded, and next thing you know, you're shooting yourself with Ipecac and there's nothing you can do about it. But eventually, when the Eden streak will end, it's kind of like, you know, people have asked me, am I going to continue playing Isaac on the channel? It's like, yeah, of course. Will I do a streak, a new streak? It's like, yeah, it probably won't be an Eden streak. This is certainly not going to be the last Eden streak I've ever done, or I'll ever do, but, data miner. But I can't necessarily say that I would jump into another Eden streak right away, just because the thought of starting over. What? Oh, there's an that thing was completely invisible. The idea of starting over is just weird to me. It's surreal, I think, is the best way to describe it. I mean, you got to remember, like, this is something that I've done for almost a year straight now. Joker card, I'm happy about that. We don't really need to spend a bomb here. No donation machine. All right, blind rage is not going to help us. The Eden streak has been part of my daily routine for almost a straight up year. So it's going to be very odd to like to record stuff for YouTube for Isaac and not be doing Eden runs. The only thing else I can think of is do like an item tournament at the beginning of every year. Curse the unknown. Sure. This is a mob trap room. How do you want to know the difference between mob trap room and boss trap room? Well, if you see the two crossed swords at the bottom of the screen, that would be a skull. And you can also, if you can look at the map, it will be orange instead of blue. But I mean, with a DPS this strong, the game's going to have to try very hard to kill us. I would have to get extremely sloppy. Although, what I will say is that we're not perfectly safe here just because of the fact we have no movement speed at all.
Oh, you're moving like you should do.
Yeah, okay. Yes, we have movement speed, but it's not at a level that I feel safe at. Movement speed is extremely important. Not as important as damage or tears rate, but it's certainly the third most important stat. Something's wrong. We really don't need that. Spent one key to get two. I'm happy with that. Got two of diamonds. Going to double our money. I'm just going to use that now. So we're looking okay right now. I know that we still have, I think, two red heart containers, maybe one. But like this two tier delay that we've got is just, this is bonkers. We essentially have. We have the best parts of soy milk without having the associated huge damage down. Soy milk is the tier delay of one, but this is like almost as good as soy milk. This is all natural soy milk. Fire mine is just not a good idea. If it was holy shot or something like that, of course I would take it. But the reason why we don't want fire mine is because of the fact that our tears rate, our massive tears rate, would actually work against us. So we don't want that. I'm doing this only because we need a key. Oh my god, we almost didn't have enough movement speed to get out of that little area. It's certainly bogging us down. Hit the full screen key there. But luckily, we did do a full clear here, just in case if anyone was worried. That streak's still going alive and well. But yeah, man, like, thinking of the Eden streak not being a part of my daily ritual of recording anymore is, like, really, really weird. And the greed, of course, I will take the Steam sale. But it's kind of like... It's kind of like, you know, what else could I really possibly do? There's not a whole lot of variance to Isaac until, which I realize is somewhat of a weird statement because obviously the game is built around being roguelike and being random. But you know what I mean, though. In the process of recording, in the process of these runs go, we're going to get a special run every now and then, but not every run special. And it's disingenuous to think that it is. It's even naive, I would say, as a content creator, it's naive to think like that, because it's like, come on. You can't expect everyone to just absolutely love everything that you do. How come I didn't use the Joker card in that floor? It's because I want to get to the 100 deal with the devil chance floor now. Because if I were to force, I have a feeling if I were to force a devil deal there, that would have been a Krampus fight. And I want to see if this one, knowing that this devil deal chance is going to be 100%, I want to see if this is going to be the Krampus one. If it's not, then I'll feel better about myself. If it is Krampus, then I won't feel good about not using the Joker card in the last floor. There's no real reason to use Joker card other than, like, you know, maybe we'll get an extra boss item or a devil deal item there towards the very end. We get a free lock here. We should see what's in this golden or this red chest, dark chest. Bunch of flies. All right. Maybe this is the right way to go. Dude, this movement speed, though, man. When I gotta hold on for dear life just backing away from one of these really slow shots, that's when you know you're in trouble. Prayer card. I mean, sure, I guess. Telepills! Okay, so Telepills is gonna get us out of... Okay, now I feel good about not using the Joker card, because that last floor was probably Krampus. Telepills is gonna get us out of the boss rush here, so we just need to find boss rush now. We get Sack Dagger, of course. Sack Dagger, one of my favorite items in the game, is gonna give us a lot of extra offense. Not that we needed it, of course. And there's no freaking no donation machine, of course not. I don't really want Sack of Sacks. I will take the 9-volt. I will take the tarot cloth.
Judgment.
Double judgment. No, thank you. Another eternal heart. Okay. Oh yeah, I'll take a half price blue map. And I'll take a mystery gift. We don't honestly need Guppy's head. As dumb as that may seem, we don't need it. I'd rather take this gift to an angel deal, or at least the cathedral. I can wait till the cathedral. It's fine. We don't have chaos, so we're guaranteed to get an angel item.
Oh, you should go do the lamb, Victor.
Nah, I don't want to do the lamb. Unless if we got flying or a major movement speed upgrade. Delirium, Hush, the lamb's just not on the table. I really don't want to mess with them with this movement speed. No, I'm not saying that we would die, of course. I'm just saying that it'd be an unnecessary, a hugely unnecessary risk.
You gotta be risky. You gotta live once in a while.
I think I've... Over the course of this streak, I feel that I've made some pretty risky decisions. We've had some really nutty moments. I wish there was someone out there who would love me. And also, that was like the saddest thing ever. I didn't mean that. I wish there was someone out there who actually, like, was taking notes of, like, their favorite moments and since the streak began, and then would point me in the right direction where we could do, like, a montage, like, of everyone's top streak moments of the first year, something like that, you know? But that would be a huge undertaking. Especially if someone doesn't already have a running count like that. Polaroid. We already knew it was in the deal with the devil. I just checked in there anyway, just out of force of muscle habit. Strategy Gaming, and Papilla Duplex or Cancer. We'll take Cancer only because it gives us the wafer effect. We'll teleport out of there, and we'll head on down to the next floor in a very, very strong run. It's hard to have not have a strong run with freaking two-tier delay. The Mystery Gift, by the way, will give us an item pedestal which adheres to whatever the loot table is in the room that we use it in. But somebody, of course, lost, of course. Somebody asked me tonight on stream if if people unfollowing the channel bothered me, or people unsubbing from YouTube bothered me. I think this person was a YouTuber themselves, or an aspiring one. And you can't, for me, like, I don't get bothered by that. The only thing that I would say comes close to bothering me is just not knowing why someone would unfollow, that sort of thing. But you're not really meant to know, like, why. Like people don't have to give you a reason. Maybe they just get bored of you, or they're just time to move on, or whatever. But, like, I think too many YouTubers or streamers in particular dwell on that. They get, like, bent out of shape. Like, I have friends who get bent out of shape when they lose, like, a bunch of subs, or, like, they, you know, they play a game people didn't like, they unfollow. You know, I feel like you can't really do that, or you shouldn't, in my opinion anyway. I don't. I'm speaking for myself here. It doesn't bother me that much. You know, it's unrealistic to think that people will just love everything that you do. Like you could just turn on music for an entire night without having any gameplay at all. You're just sitting just like... I knew I shouldn't have walked out of there. I don't know why I'm doing this. You know what? We'll get that Solar back. I cannot move fast enough to get to have even gotten out of the vortexes there. That's how slow we are. I literally could not move. Yeah, we're not moving. Anyway, as a content creator, you shouldn't expect everything that you do to be just solid gold. Not everyone's gonna love it. And you can't be bothered. You really shouldn't dwell on, like, you know, oh, I lost a bunch of followers and stuff. You know, like, I lost, like, 30 followers in the last 2 days from doing the editing, and that's okay. I don't blame them. That's what I say. I don't blame people for unfollowing. As I opened up the start of this video today, you know, I'm like, you know, if you're somebody out there who unfollows for stuff like that, like, you know, if you just really love Minecraft and your favorite Minecraft streamer decides he's gonna play Fortnite for a night or something like that, or maybe make it a new thing, give it a chance. You know, it may not be your thing, but it might become your new thing. Who knows? You know, were you following this person because of the game, or were you following it because of their personality? That's the one key difference that I think a lot of people may miss in this discussion. Because if you're following for a game, then I would say, why bother following the channels that play the game? I think it's all about aligning expectations as a viewer and as a streamer. You know, on the one hand, you've got people who just they're gonna love everything you do, the diehard out there. And then on the other hand, you got the fair weather ones, the ones that are only there just because they saw you stream this one game the one time and they think that's your game. You know, you fall into that one game. That one game scenario, the sort of pigeonhole. Let's just give it a chance, and even if you still don't like it, then you know you can unfollow them if you want. I ain't gonna cry over it. Someone might cry over it, but it ain't gonna be me. I really, really wish that we didn't have Curse the Lost. This is slowing us down. Like this is going even slower than normal because of our redonkulously low movement speed. 0.63 movement speed is just atrocious. I mean, it's just awful. It's the only bad thing about this run. Everything else is great. Having a two-tier delay, having fantastic DPS because of the tier delay. And then rock up here. definitely rock and rolling McDonald's over here. McDonald's. Remember McDonald's? McDonald's was the place. That was the place to be in Bermuda. When the island got a McDonald's, man, it was like a national freaking holiday. Everyone was going nuts. I mean, you got to remember, in Bermuda, we didn't have much. The only thing that we had was heaven on earth and the most beautiful place on earth, and that was it. We didn't want that, man. We want some freaking cheeseburgers. I remember the first time I tasted a chocolate milkshake from McDonald's as a kid. I freaked out, man. I was like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do with these tastes, but it is the most delicious thing that's ever been delished. Dark Bum, I'm not taking Mom's knife. No way. No way. Dark Bum, contract from below. Get the coal, of course. I'm pretty sure we started with. So why am I going to take the white pony? Because it gives us flying, but more importantly, it gives us more movement speed. It doesn't give us 1.5 movement speed, but it's I can no longer tolerate this movement speed. I really can't. We're just so freaking slow, man. And Conquest Pony, of course, is also a fantastic boss-killing item because you have Crack the Sky attached to it. Telepills, range up, you don't know me like that. Range up, I'm gonna bring this one back. That was us charging. That was Isaac using Conquest Pony to charge. That's the movement speed that we're talking about right here. That is terrible. That might be the slowest I think I've ever seen Conquest Pony charge, or anything charge in this game. That looked like that. We looked like a mob that was being affected by the stopwatch right there. That was just hilarious. There we go on that. All right, take a hit there. Yeah, Dark Bum, why don't you skedaddle on over there? Necesito mucho soul hartos. Sounds like a delicious cereal. I haven't had cereal in a while. Name your favorite cereal. That's going to be the next Sinvicta tournament right there. Ultimate Sinvicta Cereal Tournament. Which one reigns supreme? I can't even do my fake epic voice now. My voice is raw, man. Been doing way too much talking, not drinking enough water, not sleeping enough. This tournament's going to be the end of me. Not really, though. Why did we not get hit by that explosion? We're not Bob. We don't have a transformation that gives us explosion immunity. That was weird. It's like we bounce off of that explosion like we did have explosion immunity, but we don't. I don't understand. No comprendo. Yeah, man, McDonald's was like, that was like heaven. It really was like heaven on heaven on earth, you know. Every single kid from every part of Bermuda was just clamoring at the idea of going back to McDonald's. And then you talk about, if you think you know a long line, you've not seen a long line until you've seen the only McDonald's on your island on a summer day at the start of summer vacation. McDonald's, from what I remember, had like two counters in there and like maybe one person at the desk at all times. That was it. We're not talking about America here. We're talking about Bermuda. We're talking about a place that's less than the size of the city that I'm close to by more than like a third. We're talking a very, very tiny, teeny tiny place. The fastest you can drive on this mile is 25 miles an hour, or this island is 25 miles an hour. And trust me, that takes, when you're traveling that slow, it takes a long time to go anywhere. Like from one end to the other, like from St. George's to course, we would get Curse of the Lost again after getting, you know, the blue map. Hey, we reached our soy milk levels. Sure, we'll take fruitcake. Why the hell not?
We got teleported directly to Blue Baby. Who cares about Curse of the Lost? This is the greatest run ever.
Cricket's body, by the way, is the one that gave us splash damage and gave us the tears up, but wow. I can't believe that Telepills just took us straight to Blue Baby. That was the fastest I've ever seen the chest without having an Emperor card. Hey, try that on for size. Natural soy milk run. I love it. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Remember to go out there and vote for your favorite Isaac item in the tournament going on right now. Thank you for your ideas for the like streak as well. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.